To combat climate change, we need to pay special attention to sectors with high and growing energy demand, like data centers. In Europe, data center demand accounts for 2.9% of electricity use and growing steadily. In China, which is home to roughly a quarter of the world's data centers, their electricity demand is 2.7% of the national total. Up until now, data center operators mainly pay attention to energy efficiency, which remains critically important. In the future, data center operators are considering other ways to go green. Today, we're going to discuss flexibility, which is important for integrating variable wind and solar energy into data center energy consumption. It's especially important to consider ways to integrate renewable energy into data centers. The most obvious way is rooftop solar, but since data centers use a lot of energy, rooftop solar can produce only less than 1% of their consumption. The rest will have to be purchased from the market, either via power purchase agreements or directly through spot power markets. Global internet brands like Google and Microsoft have been leaders in procuring renewables. In a future power system with a high share of wind and solar, data centers could play a new role as a flexible demand for the grid. This would help the power system balance variable renewable output, but would represent a change from present practices. In the early 2010s, several studies by researchers at Lawrence Berkeley National Lab showed how data centers could be more flexible. Some data centers have flat power consumption, but some have highly variable consumption over the course of a day. This reflects different loads, such as video streaming and database updating. Some data loads have greater priority, but currently, data centers treat them all roughly the same. For example, compare video conferences, gaming, and streaming video on one hand, versus a scientific model run, database update, or search engine web crawl on the other. LBNL experiments showed that by classifying loads, they could shift a substantial amount, as much as 40%, into off-peak hours. LBNL also experimented shifting 30% of load from one data center to another, called geographical load shifting. Both techniques could enable data centers to take up more renewables by matching their power consumption to when or where renewable energy is available. In theory, a well-functioning electricity spot market, or green power market, could enable data centers to do both. But is this really realistic? In our study, researchers from dena, GIZ, North China Electric Power University, and Greenpeace reached out to experts to evaluate these ideas and how the industry views their practicality. Our interviews and workshops showed that there remain substantial barriers to data center flexibility in practice.
In China, power markets are at an early stage, and data center awareness of the potential for greater flexibility is quite low. Most data center operators are focused mainly on providing reliable data services and view energy costs as a part of doing business. While Chinese data centers are closely monitoring best practices on efficiency, only a couple have pursued renewable energy as a strategy.
The experts we interviewed reported bandwidth and reliability could pose a problem for geographical load shifting. Bandwidth is already an issue when considering relocating data centers to cooler climates and zones with clean energy.
For example, one data center professional in China notes, currently, the state of the bandwidth has not reached a point where it can be interconnected. It would be unacceptable if cross-regional scheduling of tasks caused business delays.
Data centers also note there are no standards for classifying and prioritizing data loads. Their only incentives right now are speed and reliability. Though price changes might incentivize some flexibility, the experts we talked to said that Chinese data centers currently have the incentive to keep their electricity demand stable, to lock in a cheaper price.
For example, one Chinese data center operator said, "Data center loads are a premium load for the power system, which offers lower prices for such a load. Coal power plants prefer this kind of load to reduce the loss of startup and shutdown. Flexible operation could result in data centers losing the benefit of their current low electricity tariffs on bilateral contracts."
This goes directly against the flexibility and means that other loads have to be more flexible because data loads are inflexible.
In Germany, we have a framework for flexibility in place with a functioning spot market for electricity, with negative wholesale prices at times when there is a high renewable output.
For example, one German operator says, "We run cost-intensive HPC software that is operated 24/7 in an overbooked state under full load. A business model in which load management would be lucrative is not discernible."
In both Europe and China, going green is the future direction. But our discussions suggest that electricity prices alone won't drive data centers to become more flexible or take up low-cost renewable energy. One possibility is that the market helps pull the data center industry towards more renewable uptake, such as if internet companies set carbon neutrality goals and 100% renewable energy goals, and demand data centers to play their part. In China, the government may also mandate that the sector to become more flexible as a part of its carbon peaking and neutrality strategy.
Information and standards could also provide a part of the solution. Our interviews showed that data center customers and operators both want more information on the energy consumption of data centers, not just on PUE, but also on renewable energy. Load shifting would need clear indications of which loads have priority, and this requires cooperation across companies and countries. The distinction between live video streaming and video conferencing on one hand versus search engine web crawling or scientific database updating might seem clear-cut, but there are a lot of gray areas in practice.
Policymakers can address data center flexibility at an early stage. The industry needs incentives in order to become more flexible. For example, if data centers can match renewable energy output, they can benefit from lower interconnection costs or priority connection. Policymakers can provide incentives for data centers to work with aggregator companies. These companies can help data centers manage loads, deploy on-site batteries, and engage in heat recovery and reuse.
In China, policymakers will likely need to lay out a clear timetable and steps for data centers to go green. Carbon neutrality is a clear long-term direction. But right now, data centers are looking only at efficiency, and price incentives for flexibility are likely inadequate, even when spot markets are introduced. One near-term change that could go a long way is removing preferential pricing for stable loads, which creates a potentially perverse incentive. Recent power shortages show that the need for more flexible loads. If data centers absorb more renewables and become more able to shift loads, they could be given a higher priority in orderly power consumption that govern power cuts during shortfalls.
In our study, we set out to answer three questions related to data center flexibility and renewable energy integration. Is data center flexibility feasible? Do data centers have the tools to become flexible? And do data centers have adequate incentive to become flexible? In this report, we lay out these and other findings and recommendations from our data center study. We find that although data center flexibility is feasible, data centers lack the tools and incentives to become flexible. Surprisingly, the development of electricity spot markets or ancillary services markets with fluctuating power prices appears insufficient to incentivize action on flexibility from data centers. More incentives from policymakers and IT users are needed. A clean and low-carbon energy system is the goal, and sectors with rising electricity loads have to play their part. Our society relies on data and information processing as a basic daily necessity. Working together by increasing incentives for flexible data center operations, we can meet our economy's IT needs in a cleaner, greener way.